just like you got to figure out if you're the right type of person, if you have the right type of personality, character traits to deal with this. If you're in a relationship, then that person has to be an independent thinker. It has to be somebody who can deal with you being gone and not being, you know, so lonely that nigga, she going to be, or he or she is going to be seeking the comfort and company of other people outside the relationship. I'm talking about in an intimate capacity. You know what I'm talking about. It's healthy to have friends, should have friends. But you gotta have the right mindset. The right attitude. She gotta have a positive attitude. She gotta be an independent thinker. He or she gotta be an independent thinker, because a lot of the general population makes negative assumptions about truck drivers. Few bad apples give us a terrible reputation. There are people who are here that cheat, ruin marriage, ruin relationships, feel like out of sight, out of mind, go do whatever. Well, if there's trust issues in a relationship, woo, trucking is going to make it a serious challenge in most cases. And if the relationship is strong, either of the two people are not very suitable for being in a relationship, then it could be challenging on a relationship. Think about it. What I come across is oftentimes each person in the relationship desires for and waits for the other person to treat him or her the way they want to be treated first. And then they might respond by treating that other person better. Think about that. That's like a standoff. Each person is waiting on the other one to treat them the way they want to be treated, and then they don't even communicate how it is they want to be treated. So you are expecting the other person to read your mind and know what they're doing wrong and correct it. See what I'm saying? That's a problem. So communication is a big deal. Trucking or not, in a relationship, communication is a deal. If you're trucking, it's an even bigger deal. Because you have to be able to express your feelings, your emotions, your desires, your wants, your needs to the other person. Now you gotta help the other person. I mean, you gotta hope the other person is of the type who cares enough to work on doing what they can do to improve the relationship. Now, in order to care, the person must be empathetic and must be considerate, must be compassionate, must be able to see things from another person's point of view. Another issue that people have today that is an affliction in their relationships, whether personal, intimate, business, whatever, even business to customer, same thing, is failing to be able to put themselves in another person's shoes. Not seeing things from another person's perspective. Not understanding the journey that someone else is going through. Not being able to see the challenges that they have, the experiences that they have. And if they're able to see it, not being able to feel it to the degree, or having a desire to understand it, to understand where that person's coming from. And if that was the case, if they are able to work on and master that, improve in that area, then you build stronger relationships. You see? So we're really talking about life skills. We're really talking about personal development. And of course, the degree with which you are competent in that area will contribute to not only your relationship, personal relationship, but how well you're able to do life in general. Think about that. But anyway, all of these are things that you should consider before becoming a truck driver. It's definitely not for everyone. Money management is something that you will have to be good at as well. help you out right now. One of the issues that new drivers have is because they're, in many cases, they're making more money than they've made before. And they get into a cycle where they start spending money, creating new bills, making new debt. And now all the money that they're making is going right back out. So it doesn't matter that they're making new money. They're not saving any. You're in the same situation that you was in. And you have to work all the time. You can't take breaks because you have created these bills. You have increased your cost of living. I would like for you to consider not doing that. I would like for you to not do that. Take it from me, you know, I wasted a whole lot of money early on. And that money could have been much better spent saving it to buy a truck, which I did buy a truck. I got a truck now, but I wasted a whole lot of money. That's ridiculous. $500, $600, $700, $800 a month. Throwing away, just throwing away phone bills, all kind of ridiculous stuff. You need to get you a cooler. Plug into the cigarette lighter, that's going to save you on food. It's expensive to eat out all the time. And you can get healthier food if you take it with you. And you need to monitor your spending. A lot of people that are in relationships, unfortunately, there's a lot of complaints of there not being enough money sent back home. It's not that the driver don't make enough money, it's just that they spend it. And for new drivers, especially if you're coming out here and you hadn't been working, you might have limited funds in the beginning and you start getting advances. And that's another cycle. You get these advances and you don't monitor your spending, then you spend it all, and every week you get an advance. Some drivers at the end of the week, they're always in a hole, you know. That could be stressful, of course. You work on your psyche. Feel like you're working for nothing. When you're not really working for nothing, you got in the hole at an early stage of the game. So avoid that, y'all. Avoid that. If you get in the truck and avoid that. These are things to avoid. Again, I want to touch on out of sight, out of mind for some of you guys. You'll be going out the community, out of the area for the first time, all over the country, you know. Watch yourself. Watch yourself. Don't be tempted. You'll have free time every now and then. You could go out if you wanted to in these different towns, but watch yourself. You can't have alcohol on your breath as a truck driver, and you don't want to be getting involved with people all over the country. As far as intimate, you know, relationships, non-relationships. That's going to distract you, for one, and for two, if you go to making babies all along the country, tell me how you're going to get ahead like that. Mention, I'm gonna tell you what my dad, mom and dad told me is that these people have hearts. These people are people too. So they said, they used to brag about how many phone calls. Like, you understand these people, that women are people too, right? Like, they got hearts. This, that, the other, you know. So, okay, yeah. This young buck took a while to sink in, but yeah, now I get it. What you do to or for another person, you do to or for yourself. It's called karma. Things come back at you, you know? So, again, some people feel like out of sight, out of mind. It doesn't, what they don't know won't hurt them. It will hurt them. It's gonna hurt you if you care. If you're any type of quality person, it's gonna affect you in most cases at some level. Some of the trucker wives complain about seeing a shift in attitude. For one, the person don't call home as much. They're less interested. Conversations are not conversations. The talk time is much shorter because there's lack of conversation. And a lot of times the guys probably don't even realize it. It's just the end result of splitting your attention and focus between more than one person. You know, now you're having different experiences, different conversations outside the home. Of course, your affection and focus relationships. That's what I'm talking about. People who are in relationships and trying to keep it strong and ongoing. People who are smart enough to be proactive, nurture the relationship, and not allow the distance apart, time apart, destroy, and temptation destroy the relationship. So that's something that you will have to have the personal responsibility to manage well. Again, we're talking about what? We're talking about personal development. Unfortunately, they don't place enough focus, time, and attention on in this area in school. It should be a required curriculum. It should be a required curriculum.
This person can sit back and have a more objective perspective.
You're a new parent, you're a young parent, if you're a parent at all, be sure to make up for what's not being done in the schools. And at the end of the day, it's our responsibility to make sure our children are ready to transition into adulthood. It's our responsibility. But it will help that this type of learning is institutionalized so that every kid is given this perspective and can work on those skills at starting at an early age. That would be a smart thing for government to do. But where does the responsibility really lie? It lies in the home. It's just that from where are you to get this perspective? You know? Some people don't. Are not going to be fortunate enough to have parents to introduce them to this perspective on life. That's why it should be institutionalized. That's why it should be part of the curriculum in school. But that's okay. We're there now. You're hearing, if this is a new concept to you, you got it now. And this video is not about parenting, so I'm going to leave it right there. I hope no one takes this as an attack on your parenting skill. Really do need personal development, because that's not what I just did. What I just did, I hope, but I know I helped to enlighten a couple of people, but hopefully a lot of people just took something positive away from that, and you're not one of these people running around feeling like a victim and receiving life through that filter, because that's, again, that's evidence for the need of personal development. You can't have a wonderful, enjoyable, happy life going around feeling like a victim and feeling oppressed every day. You need to get out of that mindset if that's you. Get out of that mindset. You gotta enjoy life, man. You gotta think about what you want, set some goals, and decide on what things you're gonna do every day that's in line with those goals so that you can work toward it. And understand that you are to enjoy the journey. Enjoy the journey. You don't have to wait until you get to where you want to go to begin enjoying the journey. It's called balance. It's called right perspective. It's called positive mindset. It's called positive attitude. It's called pleasing personality. It's called living well. See, some people just exist. The reason I do all of this, I'm talking, go into all these areas, is because I don't want you to just exist. I want you to live well. I want you to live. Keyword is live. Some people exist. You want to live. Enjoy life. Life is a journey. Wondering about how this works out being on the road for all that time. Where do you sleep? Of course, you sleep in the truck. Over the road trucks have bunks. They have beds back there. Twin size bed. Where do you take a shower and how often are you able to shower? Truck stops have showers. They're free for the most part. If you get fuel at that type of truck stop, then you get the shower for free. the ship or the receiver, or near the ship or receiver, or you're going to drive as far as you can drive in the day, which is 11 hours, and that spot that you have to sleep at is not going to be somewhere that has showers, you know? It's just going to be a truck park. It might even be around, you know? Again, it's all goes back to time management, but bottom line is, no, you won't be able to take